Hi, Jody and Molly. So here's some feedback on your draft four, some of the things which I think you should be having a play with when you come back to kind of really polish it off. I know there's a little section at the end which still needs some work doing. I think one of the things I think consistently throughout the videos is the colours. There's some lovely colours. I mean, your under the water shots are gorgeous. You know, the colours are beautiful there. They're interesting. There's a lovely dappled sunlight pattern coming through the water, which looks great. And of course, that's, you know, quite an interesting symbolic code in terms of him drowning in love or absent love or something like that. But there are other colours which I think you might be able to replace or push a little bit more with hue, lightness, and saturation effect. I think these sea shots, some of them are very grey. I know sea can be very grey, especially on dull days, but you might be able to get something a bit punchier out of that. And also the blood. I think that's such an important element because that kind of illustrates your lyric so clearly. You know, and the name of the song is Bloodstain, and the broken relationship has become a bloodstain. So that, and I'm 90% sure you get much brighter, vibrant kind of scarlet out of that shot, because at the moment that's a bit too muted, I think. So let's try some color corrections. It might be secondary colors, but I'd have to have a little play when you get back.
Been in and out of love since I was 19. Opening my heart has left a blood stain. And I don't know how to make a man stay.
I think that's a key line. I don't know how to make a man stay, because this is all about his inability to stay in a relationship with somebody. And I think possibly a better shot, which will clearly kind of anchor the meaning between the song and the video, is the shot when Sam walks out of frame, leaving Noah there, kind of bereft, looking kind of lonely and longingly after him, rather than this shot, which is more abstract and which you use several times. You know, so that I'd swap those two around, because I think that illustrates the lyric more clearly at that point. Or the video illustrates the lyric more clearly at that point.
Maybe I've been putting my heart out in the wrong way. And I'm bleeding.
That feels to me a fraction of a second out. You know, it doesn't quite finish. Your rhythmic doesn't quite finish on the beat. Just carries on for a tiny fraction of a second, and it's just enough that I can see it. You know, I think I want to hit that moment with the song absolutely clearly. So stop there, but you come back in again. Okay, so I want you to ditch that frame just before then on that black. At 40 seconds, I'm not that one, maybe it's that one. You know, I just think that you just run over it a bit and miss the beat. I also think on some of these static shots of Noah by the pool as well, I think you could push in on those a little bit. And I'd push in to push Noah up against this edge. I'd kind of push in this edge a little bit. You know, maybe keep the water in, and so pushing on this side and crop across the top a bit. And that's so you'd be pushing him effectively against that side of the frame, which I think would be quite nice. Semic code, which interprets a sense of entrapment and loss. So So for here, I mean, the example is really clear here. You know, what we need is really bright, vibrant red. The problem is, I suppose, if we push that red, Noah's face is going to go in a really weird color, because obviously that's in the same sort of area of the color wheel. So we might have to try and isolate that color and be quite specific about which color we're pushing. I'd have to look that up, how to do that, because it'll be awful. The worst effect would be is if suddenly Noah turns beetroot red as well. And again, I think you overrun it there as well. Stop there, but you come back in for another frame. I think you've got to hit that. You know, one of these things is editing to the rhythm. I'm not sure what's going on there. I don't like it at all. I was thinking that a second ago here. I was thinking, aren't we going to be blending in some more of these C shots? You know, I mean, you might be able to download a kind of a bit of video which has got kind of more swirling patterns within it. It doesn't have to be the C. Maybe it could be more abstract. But I'd get that fixed more consistently. Yeah, a lot of showing that one goes out of focus. It's not like the framing. Found the one when I was 23. And when it was done, it nearly killed me. I've got a little heart, not the fool. I think you should crop this a bit. Okay, take off the wall. I mean, I love the wall. Alternatively, maybe crop it that side. Maybe crop it down there and across. Push him again towards the frame. It's just he's a bit central here. I'd like either you to give him proper lead space by cropping this side of the frame, or compress his lead space by cropping this side of the frame. So, but let's get him off the center. One night. Give it all away even when I know it isn't right. And I'm bleeding. See, so, that was perfectly timed. Again, I think it's just another, just one too far. You know, I wouldn't come back into the diving board that last time. Okay, so what's going on here? Why suddenly Noah's within this frame, within a frame? Have you cropped in and not zoomed? Gonna pull myself together. Gonna wait till it's forever. Gonna find someone who'll stay, who's not afraid of what I'm asking for. I know love is never easy. With the scar that's gonna leave me, I would rather love him. Yeah, this one on really as red as we can get this area of the screen. I never feel love at all. It'll bleed it. I like the way he sinks under the bloody water at the end. That's nice, and that's a nice kind of conclusion to the video of kind of despair. I think you need to add a fade there. I think you need to fade that out to black or to white or something like that. It's called dip to black, I think, if you're looking for that transition type. But as he sinks in, the video kind of fades away with the song, rather than it just kind of an abrupt cut. So there's not much more to do. As I said, I think it's the colours I want you to play with a little bit more. And that timing on that edit just feels slightly out. You know, that repeated, you know, that very staccato edit to go on with that kind of little staccato piece. But well done.